even shout out to Faisal. After everything we've been through.
Welcome back to another episode of The Fifth Quarter, powered by LBA. Today's guest is Zachary Lofton, a.k.a. Slime.
Here you go. Nothing, man. Just go back to Lebanon. Having the time of my life. You know how that go.
Okay, okay. Well, like, what made you come back to Lebanon?
Well, I just got done in the Philippines.
Okay.
Looking for a job, trying to figure out where I want to go, China, Taiwan. Chose Lebanon.
Okay, because we saw you like 3 months ago here.
Right.
And there were a lot of rumors you coming back to Sagesse, especially, you know, having Kojad and a few of your teammates, you know, Bobo, Kareem, AI. Anyways, like a lot of Dynamo players there.
Right.
So it was like, you know, kind of like the perfect fit for you.
Yeah.
What happened?
We got into negotiations and they offered something and then the Philippines team came in with a bigger offer. And
okay.
We were trying to match, they didn't get to it, and then they end up taking Pierre. So
okay.
That's all it was. So it's simple. We had a bigger offer.
That's okay. Okay. And how was your time in the Philippines?
I loved it, man. You went there, right? You went to go play?
Yeah. But I went there, it was like probably 5 days. It was a quick trip. We just played against the Gilas and just left.
Yeah, I liked it a lot. The people are nice, the food. You know, it was a great time. Basketball was good. Yeah. I've been wanting to play in that league too, so it all worked out.
Is it a tougher league than Lebanon?
No, it's different. East Asian, I mean, them leagues are a little bit different. You know, Lebanon is more competitive. It's like, it's harder. You know, over there, they have talent, but the league's a little bit different. So I would say Lebanon's a little bit tougher.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So now you're back here. What happened, man? Because I heard Beirut, Hometman, Sagesse, and I don't know if Riyadi was in there too.
Mm-hmm.
What made you choose Hometman? Why not Sagesse? Why not Beirut? Why not Riyadi?
It's a lot to unpack. All right, but
take your time. We got time.
Nah, for sure. So I came here. When I was leaving the Philippines, I was going to the U.S., but I came here. Non-basketball related stuff. I came here just to chill, you know. Then I got with some people. I met with a couple teams. I had to stop this rumor right now, bro. Sagesse said, I don't know where this came from. I'm not saying who exactly said it. They said I asked them for $80,000 a month, bro.
That's a rumor?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a rumor.
That's
$80,000, guy.
Okay, yeah.
I didn't ask them for $80,000. Coach Jada called me. He asked me, am I done in the Philippines? No one knew I was going to be done. I wasn't supposed to be done until February 7th, but some things happened. And then they ended up going with someone else. And then I was talking to Beirut. Negotiations fell through. I don't like to get into too much detail, but we were talking to them. And then something happened with Kalen Lucas, one of their imports. I was getting ready to leave to Taiwan. I was about to sign to Taiwan. And then something happened with their import. They were like, yo, we got this. They met everything I asked for, which was great. And I want to stay in Lebanon. My people are here, so. And then ultimately I signed with them, which I'm happy about, you know. At first, I'm not gonna lie, I didn't have no intentions on signing with him, man. I thought Walter was there, everything was good, and then they had Kalen coming.
Yep.
I'm like, I'm happy for them. But then it ended up, shit, it was me.
To be honest, I feel like Zack Lofton in Hometman is a perfect fit, you know? As soon as I heard the news, I was super happy. Of course, Walter is like a huge player, you know, like with the...
Hell yeah, I played, he beat me in Kuwait finals. Tough.
Oh, he beat you in Kuwait in finals? Yeah, he's tough.
Him and Kiki.
But I feel like you're going to bring probably something else on the table that they needed. And I like the character is going to change, you know, like just having a change, even if Walter is like a huge player, like having Zack Lofton, I feel like it's going to like wake up everyone because I don't know who took the decision. If it was Walter leaving, he took the decision or the management. But this is going to be like a big change for them. And I was scared for Chanville, by the way, because, you know, we're fourth right now and they're fifth.
Yeah.
And we're competing to, you know, for the ranking.
I'm hoping that we play y'all.
We're going to beat you guys.
I didn't get to see you. I didn't get to see IT. You know
what I'm saying? IT, man, we got Zack Lofton talking a lot of, yeah.
I told him come today, too, and he didn't come, so I really don't like him.
IT?
Yeah, and Moose showed up, though. That's my guy.
Shout out to Musa.
Yeah.
And so having this unfinished business from last year, what is Zack Lofton's going to do this year? Is he going to the finals? Do you have goals for this year?
Hell yeah, I got goals. I had goals when I signed back in Lebanon with Dynamo, and then all that stuff happened with them. And then, bro, you last year that we had a chance, you know. And then the game we lost when Diop went down, and we didn't finish that game. It hurts, bro, not to win. You know, we're winners.
Yeah, for
but
sure.
Obviously, I try to come win. You know, it's not about just Zack Lofton or nothing like that. I want to come win. So, I mean, I'm not gonna say we're definitely gonna win the league, but for sure gonna try.
Yeah, for sure. So. I'm asking that question because a lot of people say Zack Lofton is high maintenance. Like, he's just coming for the money. Like, he wants like nice cars, nice houses, whatever. But knowing you personally, I know like you like to compete, you know, especially not just in games, even in trainings. Like, you get pissed in trainings too. Can you tell me more about that? Are you high maintenance?
No, I'm not. I want my shit to be clean. Oh, my bad. It's cousin. I want my stuff to be clean, though. You know, I don't need the nicest anything, but I want to get treated appropriately. You know,
exactly.
I'm coming from 7,000 miles away. I want to feel good. Like, when I go to practice, I want to come back and be comfortable, not like, you know, come to some dirty something. I mean, I love nice stuff.
For sure.
You know? For sure. But as far as high maintenance, no, I'm really down to earth. Like, you know me as personally. I'm not really like that. It's a lot of perceptions about me that's not real, but I don't have time to
think about
negate
it.
And think about that and tell everybody that's not me.
Exactly.
Can I ask you a question?
Ask me a question.
What made you start this?
Oof.
Very tough. 'Cause you're good at it.
Okay. I'm about to tell you. So I was at a birthday dinner.
Mm-hmm.
And I met Zad Beshalani.
Okay.
Which is a partner in LBA. And I didn't know of LBA. It didn't exist at the time. And by the way, LBA is the app. I don't know if you know about it.
No, I know about it, yeah.
Okay.
It's lit, actually.
Yep. And he showed me their roadmap and what they wanted to do. But you know, in Lebanon, it's always all talk, no action. And once he showed me the roadmap, I really believed in the project. And I was really interested to, you know, work with them. So that's how it started. We all watch NBA and we saw that players would do podcasts.
Mm-hmm.
And I asked the whole team, you know, is this possible? And they said yes. So I was like, all right, let's do it. Let's do a podcast. And, you know, it's nice to have another perspective of basketball because, you know, journalists, they're going to like ask you like, you know, regular questions. For me, it was like more, I want to know who the person in front of me is.
Yeah.
I know what I can ask them, what makes them uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that's it, you know, giving another perspective on knowing people. Because, you know, like everyone is like, yeah, Zack Lofton has like a terrible attitude, all this.
Asshole, I hate it.
Exactly. So, you know, having you here, I want to show them that who the real Zack is, you know, nice guy. Competitive.
I really be chilling, bro.
I know. So that's why I started the podcast.
Yeah, okay.
And until now, it's going well, and I hope to, you know.
So now I got a future because I asked you a question, you answered. So like, we could switch spots right now.
There you go.
No.
And okay, coming back to, you know, you telling me that you're like, you know, 70,000 miles or whatever from, you know, home. Is it hard to be away from your family?
Yes and no. Back in college, though, people don't know. I went to like 4 or 5 different colleges.
Mm-hmm.
So straight from high school, I've been away. So I get used to being away. And then now, you know, we're making money. We have a career. We have families and stuff. You take care of people. So I like put that in the back of my mind, like, you know, my mom, my daughter, everybody, I love them, but I'm out here handling my business. I'll see you when I get to you. Not in a mean way, not like I don't have feelings, I don't miss people, but if you let that get to you too much, it affects you, it affects your game. Like,
Performance.
end of the day, you're here to do a job, you know?
Exactly.
You can get changed like this. You've seen it,
Exactly.
I've seen it, you
Exactly.
know? So I
Cool.
miss them, but I try to focus on doing well here, because if I do good well here, then
You can't take care of them.
it's gonna help
Exactly.
them.
And we all know you went to the Pistons.
Yeah.
How was this as a experience?
It was crazy, man, because a lot of people think I got drafted. I didn't get drafted.
Okay.
I got a summer league job out of college.
Okay.
So I went to 11 workouts out of NBA. I'm gonna give you a quick story like this. Right out of college, I had 11 or 12 NBA workouts. Pistons liked me the most. Went to summer league with them. Did well in summer league. They're like, okay, we'll give you Exhibit 10. Exhibit 10 is a training camp deal.
Okay.
Training camp deal. I do well in training camp. I get a deal, you know? And it was amazing, man. I stayed in college for so long because that was my goal for real. Like, I could have left and went overseas a long time ago, but like, it was the young dumb in me, but I guess it worked out. Cause I made it there. That's where I want to do my whole life, to make it to the NBA, make it to the NBA. Cause that's just what every kid wants to do from America. That's what you want to do.
Exactly. I think in the whole
In
world,
the whole
you know,
world, yeah.
being a basketball player, like
Word.
that's the ultimate goal.
So I made it. It was amazing, man. Like, how you get treated, how they treat every single player from 1 to 12, 1 to 13. Everybody gets treated great. You know,
Yeah.
my vet was Blake Griffin. He was a great guy. You
That's
know,
cool.
they treat you great, man. It was a great experience. Unfortunately, I tore my hamstring. And then after that, you know, it's business.
Exactly.
So,
Are you still in touch with like some of like
yeah.
the NBA guys?
Yeah. I love them to death. Like, when I go back home, when I travel, when I'm doing my thing, I'm always in touch with them. They watch this stuff, because I'm not saying I'm a big deal, but like, they see highlights and all
For
this stuff on
sure.
Instagram. Social media is huge now. Social media is huge now. So they see that stuff. They hit me up, like, I see you. So it's good, man. I'm just glad I got to get that experience. So
'Cause I know the other time I was talking to Jamel, my teammate this year. Earlier.
I was in free agent camp with him, Sacramento Kings. No, Raptors. Toronto
Okay.
Raptors.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, we were in free agent camp together. That's how I know him.
Anxie was telling me like right before you got here that you were talking to him. I was like, yeah, I'll ask him how he knows him. Okay, so now we know. And he was telling me, by the way, that whenever you like in the league, you have like everyone gets an iPad, and like so you can rewatch yourself
Film,
film.
yeah. You gotta get the iPad, yeah. Watch your film. Like, it's not as like an NFL. They can log your hours, see what you're doing. In ours, they didn't log our hours, but you do get your iPad, your film. They send you everything on there. Before a game, before a practice, coach will call you over. You get in the laptop. They'll show you what you're doing wrong, and that type of stuff. It's
Yeah, it helped a
crazy,
lot.
man. It's
Yeah.
crazy. It's crazy.
That's a nice experience to have.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I got a story. When I one of the vets asked me to go get them a cookie when I was on the plane. He was like, yo, go get me a cookie. I came back, give me $1,000 for getting them a cookie. The league's crazy, man. Crazy.
Yeah. I hope Zack Lofton gets back to the league. I don't know if that's your goal. Are you trying to go back? Like summer league, probably like, you know, this upcoming summer or.
Had an opportunity to play summer league last year. I went to China instead, but I don't know anymore, man.
Why did you take the decision, by the way? Because I remember you telling me, I might go. Was it the Raptors, I think?
It was a summer league job. I took it for the money, and I took it because I wanted to go to CBA
Okay.
right after.
Okay.
Everything isn't peaches and cream, you know. You have a plan sometimes, and everything don't go as planned all the time. And that situation, it was good for me, but it wasn't exactly what I wanted it to be. But as far as going back to the league, I don't know, man. It's just tough. Like, it'll be a situation where I have to go maybe to the G League and then get 10 days and all that type of stuff. But I've worked hard enough to build a profile, you know, to go to the Philippines, to get China offers, to, you know, still play in Lebanon. You know, it's growing back, you know, and that type of stuff. So I don't think I'm focused on going back unless something just jumped in my lap.
Okay.
You know, but
Yeah.
I've let that go. I'm glad I got to experience it though, so I let that
Because
be.
I know it's tough playing 82 games in like a season. It's not.
Need that money.
Sometimes I feel, yeah. Because I feel like being overseas, it's tough, of course, but it's easier than the league in like terms of schedule.
Yeah, hell yeah. It's just being away. A lot of people can't do it because they away, but you get past that and you can perform, you can build a life over here.
I'm about to change a little bit the sub, like the whole conversation. So last year with Dynamo, was it? Yeah, because we got to talk about it. We were teammates, man.
Talk about it.
How did you like it? Because it
Moose, how'd
was.
you like it? You can't see him right now. Okay. What's up?
Do you think like we could have done better?
Could we have done better? How many regular season games we played? 20? 21?
Yeah, almost.
We went 20-1 or 21-1?
Yeah, some we just lost one game, like regular season.
You know what's crazy about that? When people would be like, that's great. Definitely could have did better. Our identity changed so much throughout start to finish. You know what I'm saying? I think
What do you think happened with us? Do you think it was like, management wise, is it us as like, players not communicating well with each other?
it was a lot, man. I think I can write a book about
It's
that.
a
I can
tough
write a
one,
book
right?
about
Because
that.
the other time I was with the whole NBA team, and we were just talking about it, and I was like, you know what? Like, we basically got to the finals. Like, we made it the whole like to the end, but we just fell short,
You gotta understand, we this these accolades don't mean anything unless you win a championship. Regular season champs, we wasn't supposed to be that. Number one. Number two, we go to Dubai finals.
Exactly. I feel like this was the turning point, by the way.
And number three, we go to finals in Lebanese League. But
Do you
there were
think
some
like,
changes we made.
I feel like IT was like, a big change in
A
this,
huge
like,
change.
yeah.
A huge change. And I wish him and management would have figured that out. That's one thing I don't like speaking about because some shit you can't change.
True.
But I think IT, like you play with him now, like regardless of, I'm not even talking about on court, but like performance wise, basketball wise, but what he brings to the locker room, how he talks, how he does all that, like IT's a great man. Like he's a great teammate. He's a great leader. He's a father. He's old as shit.
Yeah,
You know what I mean? He's
my
wise. He
guy.
know what he's doing. You know, he brought me here. He brought me to Lebanon. You know, and I just feel like if he would have stayed with us. Or if he would have came back, like I love Joe. Joe did well. Joe did okay. You know, he tried
For
to come up and
sure,
do
for
his
sure,
job.
for sure.
But he didn't have that. We weren't his family. If that makes sense.
Makes sense. Makes sense.
And so I just feel like with him being gone, like it changed a lot. You know,
Yeah.
and he wasn't playing bad. He was playing well too.
True.
So, but and then we made some other changes. On the court, off the court, it's a lot, man. A lot that I mean, I want to talk about it, but it's some shit that you just
We
don't
can't
talk
say,
about.
yep.
And you know what I'm talking about. You know. You
Well.
know. But overall, I feel like we fell short, but we did something no one thought we could do. So you can be happy a little bit about that. But obviously, we want the finals, but. So
Sure,
it
sure.
hurts. It's gonna hurt for a while
For a
too,
while.
you know. But y'all just beat Beirut by damn near 20 points.
Last night?
Yeah, that
Yeah.
was a great game. I was there before my game.
Like, what do you think about us this year? Like,
I like y'all.
as Champville.
I like y'all. I like you. I like IT. I love IT. I love Jamil.
What do you think about
The
the MVP of the league?
JB.
Yeah.
He's tough.
He tough, bro.
He's tough. Even when I was over in Philippines and all that, like, 'cause first off, I came to a scrimmage when y'all was playing Antoni. Me and Lay came over there,
I
and
remember.
I was telling Lay, 'cause we had a a scrimmage before that. And they came over there. We didn't have Kareem. We didn't have another import. We had Rewan and me. I played like 5 minutes, and they were beating us, and they was talking so much. They was talking so crazy, like, oh, these guys went to the finals, blah, blah. And I'm looking at them like, are y'all serious? So then when I got to see them play against y'all, and y'all was kicking their ass, I'm like, yeah, you see what I'm saying? And then I got to see JB. Isn't JB on, right?
Javion.
Javion. And I got to see him. I'm like, he's good. Like, he was kind of chilling. Whatever, like, preseason, whatever. It's not really sick. Like, even me in hoops last, that was like a preseason game. Like, bro, we beat him by 40. Like, I had 5 points or whatever. He was chilling. And then I get to see him, these numbers he's doing, like, throughout
game
the league,
after
game after game, and it's consistent. I'm like,
he's nice.
He's nice. Yeah. I like him. I like him. I like him a lot.
And he's a great person. Like,
see, I don't. That's what I know. That's what I don't know. He looks like he's a great person. He don't.
Great person, man. Even Mel. Like, we have a great group of guys.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I love that for y'all, cause, you know, like where I'm at right now, Homemman, we have a great group of guys. You know, Coach cool, everybody cool. DJ, you know, DJ, he's funny, man.
That's my guy.
That's my. He the glue. Like, I've had glue guys in locker rooms and stuff. Like, he the glue guy. So we got that covered. You know what I mean? We got the coach. We got me. So it's gonna be fun, man. I hope we see y'all though.
And what's up with Holman?
He's a beast.
Beast, huh?
He getting in shape too. He's a beast. IT, be ready, bro.
We finished. Like, depending on the standings, we're gonna play you guys. But I think we will play you guys.
We're gonna figure it out though.
Yeah.
I'll be talking shit though, but obviously.
You're about to lose. Like, guys, I'm calling it right now. They're about to lose in the playoffs. No, I'm joking. We'll see.
No doubt.
But a good series if we do play you guys.
Yeah, before the question, I started ranting about how good your team is. What you asked me? Do you remember?
No, that was the question. I was asking you if, like, you like our team, like, you know, the chemistry and all.
Yeah, I do. I like it. And then our team, like, I don't know. Like, we beat Hoops by 40 yesterday, and I had 5 points. Like, you got to understand, like, We're good, man. We got and the thing about what I like about our team, like, I think it's like your team, probably some other teams, we don't have egos in the locker room.
Yep, that's what we don't have.
We don't have egos. We don't have somebody that thinks they too good, or, you know what I mean?
That's really important.
Like, we vibe, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
If it's a thing, like, we go out to dinner, it's not gonna be two people sit over here, three people sit over here. We together.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I think that's really important.
I want to ask you this year, because it's different than last year, the rule about the foreigners.
No. Man.
What do you think about it? Like, you like it? You don't like
it? Hell no, I don't like it. Look at y'all. Why would I like that? You got you. You got JB. You got Jimmy.
Yeah, we're all on the court. Yeah.
You're all on the court the same time.
So you think it's unfair?
Me personally, I don't think it's. I think it makes it more, a little bit more competitive, but I don't think it's fair, because you got to think, if I have three foreigners, regardless, it could be, like, Jamil has NBA experience.
Yeah.
He played at Pitt. Like,
you know, I can see that in Mel, because in those crucial times, like, he steps in, you know, he's not scared of, like, the lights, like the bright lights and whatever.
And I can guarantee you, in practice, you see his full bag. You know what I mean? In games, different. It's only 40 minutes, only one ball. But in practice, you get to see all the skills. So this is what I'm saying. So you got somebody like that, you bringing them in with you and IT and JB, MVP of the league right now. It's like three of them on the court. And let's tough. Not let you lived in Houston for how long?
6-7 years.
You damn near import too.
Yeah.
You guarded the best players. You know what I'm saying? So, like, that's four. And then you got Ellie Russell on your team now. You got Patrick.
Pick, Joe.
You got Joe.
Marvin.
You got Marvin out Lucas, there hounding player. Then you got Lucas from he went to Buffalo.
Exactly.
So you gotta understand, like, in the grand scheme of things, people don't think about that. You know what I mean? They go off for performance, oh yeah, they ain't do whatever. But now when they get to it and they in the right position.
True.
So I don't think it's fair.
True.
But they want to make it. They had to make it more competitive, because last year, you know, you go into games and it's just we going to play such and such.
By the way, I didn't watch the game last night, but y'all won by 40, 30?
40.
Yeah, you see, and they had two foreigners.
Two foreigners. And they have a great foreigner, Jesse John. I love Jesse.
Shout out to Jess.
He was on here. Yeah.
Yep.
I love Jesse. But it's just like, if they have one more foreigner, they didn't have another foreigner. And they ain't play my boy Moose. Moose is a great player too, you know.
Yeah.
But
that's your guy.
That's my boy. And the only reason why he is my boy, because he's real and he's good at basketball. If he wasn't good at basketball, I wouldn't try to help him how I help him or talk about him how I talk about him. I wouldn't do that with you. If you was ass, I wouldn't talk about you, I'd talk about you. And that's what I think people don't know about me. I'm real. Like, I have an attitude on the court. Yeah, I got an attitude. Like, no one is, everybody knows that. I'm not an asshole, but on the court, sometimes I get pissed off. And most of the time, when I get mad, I don't mean to go off into this, but when I get mad, it's really at myself. Because the ref doesn't call it, it's because I feel like I fucked up. I mean, I messed up, and I hurt the team. So I'm mad because you didn't call that call. Now it hurts my team, and it affects me too.
Yeah.
That's why I get so upset. I'm not an asshole. Off the court, ask your sister. She know I'm not no asshole.
R.I.P. to the jerseys, man. I remember in Dubai, man. We had to get you a tape. The jersey.
You know what's weird about that? I don't even want to put myself out there. I'm gonna forget it. I don't want to talk about it.
Bet. Zach, we're about to play a game called Top Picks.
Top Picks.
You're a coach and I'm a coach.
Right.
All right.
Right.
Only foreigners from last year, I guess, because you don't know the previous years, and this year. Okay? From point guard to center. Me versus you. You start. Pick a point guard. And only foreigners, by the way.
Only foreigners.
Or if you want to, we can do it like the Lebanese format. Two foreigners and three Lebanese. What do you prefer? You pick.
We do all foreigners. We can do all foreigners. And we can do all Lebanese. Do that.
It's a long one. All foreigners. Yeah, let's do it.
You go first.
Javion.
I got Jesse Jones.
All right.
Two.
I got Dar Tucker.
Dar Tucker at the two. You gotta give me some time to think about this because you know it's last year, this year. I'm new this year. At the two, I'm gonna take. You know what I'm gonna take? I'm gonna take Kerwin Roach at my two.
All right, I like that.
Kerwin Roach at my two.
I like that.
Who's your three?
I'm about to change from. Amir's episode, and I'm about to take Mel. So I'm an artist for sure, man. My teammate, my guy.
Three. I take Kevin Murphy.
You know, that was my pick with Amir, just telling you.
Take Kevin Murphy.
You want to pick your forward first?
No, you pick your forward.
All right. IT. I'm going big, bro.
IT's not a four, okay? And he loves to say that. And I hope he sees this.
He can shoot.
I want him to see this.
IT, I'm on your team, G.
Moose, is he a four?
He's not.
I can't hear you. Yes or no? No. He's not a four, but I'll give you his four.
Appreciate
to
it.
Go against IT as my four? I think foreigners only, right? Foreigners only. Come on, four. Gotta give me about 20 seconds.
You can pick Ismail Ahmed if you want to. Ismail from Riyadi. He was a foreigner. Now he's Lebanese, but he used to be a foreigner. Beast. Still plays.
When he was younger, yeah, I would have did that.
Yeah.
Sure.
But I said the past 2 years, so you can.
So help me out right now. What fours, like what fours have we had as foreigners in the last 2 years, though? Just to re-jog my memory. I done played. Let me tell you, Gab. I done played in 10 countries in the last 3 months. My mind is like.
To be honest,
so what?
Usually, the teams bring big guys, you know.
Okay, so give me a five that could play four, like IT. He's where he's a four, but he's.
Diop, Reese.
Yeah, give me him in my four.
All right,
So I'll go first as my five. I want Cliff Alexander.
Gee, that was my pick, bro. I give it to you. I give it to
So
you.
who's your five?
I'm about to get those past 2 years. I'm about to get Gamble.
Okay.
He played with Beirut like in the
Right,
preseason.
yeah. We
Gamble.
seen them.
Yep.
So who teams win, you think? So if we write
My
on paper,
team.
we write on paper. I got Jesse Jones.
Right.
Who's my Kerm Roach, Kevin Murphy, Diop, and Cliff Alexander. Who you got?
I got Chavion.
Javion, tough.
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 Dar Tucker.
Tough.
Tough. Mel. Very tough. IT. Very, very tough at the four.
Him and Diop was a good matchup.
Yeah.
Him
And
and Diop was a
Gamble at
good
the
matchup.
five. Man, we're
At the
good.
five.
I'm zoning you, by the way.
You zoning us?
Yeah.
You remember when Kerwin played us? He both times he hit three, four threes.
We'll see. They're gonna vote. The people are
The
gonna
people are gonna
vote
vote?
for sure.
That's
That's what we're
cool.
doing it.
That's cool.
Easy game.
So if we have two as far as foreigners, then we have two Lebanese,
One.
one.
Hey, the six man.
Six
Let's do a
man.
six man. Yeah.
Why not
A
seven?
Lebanese.
Okay, we take six. We might have to go to seven.
You want to do seven?
One, two.
All right, all right, all right. Go. You thought about two. I know that for sure. Go ahead.
I can't pick you, right? Because you're a coach.
Yeah, I'm a coach.
I'm gonna say mine and you say yours. I'm gonna tell you why I pick mine now. I don't need, because like YL Amir, they're like their scorers, they know how to do their thing. I want Kareem Zain-Noon. We need somebody to come in and lock. I take
Good one.
because he knows he I didn't dealt with him.
I'm about to do the same thing and go with like a young, energetic guy. And I'm gonna get my boy, Bobo. Yup. Athletic defender, energetic guy. Same profile.
And then I need somebody who can play four or five. So we gotta pick another one. Seventh man.
Go ahead.
Somebody can play four or five.
I got mine.
You got who?
I
Go
got mine.
first.
Smile Ahmad. Easy game. I
Yeah.
need this experience, bro.
Yeah.
And he's a 4-5. And Bobo's about to, like, you know, run. Get the long pass. Easy.
You got Bobo over. I don't even want to ask him questions.
Who's your second guy?
A second guy might be. Matter of fact, we need three. Right now,
We made a whole team.
I'm gonna take. I'm gonna take Ali. He come in at four out of five. He come at four or
Haidar.
five. He come in at four or five.
All right.
Now you need one more just to whatever.
Who is it?
I take Musa. I'll
Musa?
tell you why though.
Why?
Do everything.
All right.
He's about 317 pounds, 6'3". You 317 pounds? Huh? He's strong.
40 years old.
40 is 40 strong.
My guy Moose.
I take him because he do everything. You know, he got the Greece experience. You know, he know what he's doing. I just feel like he a sleeper. So who's
Okay.
gonna, you know what I mean? So tell me your third. So because he can come in, he come in from two to four damn near.
I'm about to stay with the young guys, and I'm gonna take the other Bobo from Antonine. He's a young guy, 19 years old, first year in
Anton.
the Division One, and he's
Outdoor?
balling.
Mansoor? Who?
Mansoor.
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 He's tough.
He's tough, bro.
Can't fuck with Moose yet. And I
Yeah.
say this, he's tough. I like him. Because we played him like I told you, we played him in scrimmage.
Scrimmage, yeah.
He's tough.
Yeah, he's 19, 18. He can ball, man. He
He's
can
tough.
ball. Z, that was the game. And now I'm gonna introduce the high performance coach, Maria.
I'm scared of that.
All
Come on, we gonna do it though.
right. Hi, Maria.
Yeah, I put my hood on for this. I'm scared.
You don't have to hide yet. So, how are you enjoying the interview so far?
I love it. But like I just told, I might need another one though, because Gab didn't cover everything.
What is it that you want to talk about that you still haven't talked about then?
It's okay. I'm kidding. He covered
I knew
it. He's good. He's
that.
good.
So, you guys were talking a little bit about how different teams wanted to get you here in Lebanon to be part of their teams. And now you just signed with Homentman. But having been wanted by several teams and now taken by one and having a lot of expectations on you, how do you handle the pressure of that of those expectations?
Handling expectations, staying in the gym. I work out with Eve Carr a lot. I think sometimes it goes over my head. Sometimes when I do well, I try to figure out like why am I doing so well? I don't think I'm that good sometimes, but I really work hard. Like it's not a thing where like a lot of people have a bad perception about me. Like they think I just want the expensive thing, just want to ride, be flashy. He just comes to practice and work hard. He comes to the game and just kills.
Then what do you
It's
really,
not true.
what is the
Like
truth?
even Gab knows, like I come to practice, I want to win drills. Me and IT, that's my brother, like my big brother. Me and him almost fought in practice one time because
True.
You're
we
that
want
good.
to win so much. That's how I approach things. And when I have practice, I work out. Like with Eve, I work out, skills workouts. So I think I'm so scared of failing that I work double time to be okay. Like when my expectations is to be okay, I'll be okay. Like I'll try to help my team win. But I'm so scared of failing. I work so hard so I don't mess up, if that makes sense.
Maria, by the way, sorry I'm interrupting, but Z really works super hard. Like people be asking me, like, how are his handles so tight? Like, how does he shoot that well? And I'm like, guys, you think he's just talented? Zach wakes up in the morning super early, puts in the work, goes to the gym, and he doesn't go once a day. He goes to the gym twice before practice, after practice.
I want to talk about
And
these
at
things.
night, he goes back and shoot extra shots. So just,
Yeah, it takes these practices and that kind of routine to really get you from good to great. You're an exceptional player and everybody knows that. And it's that kind of work that really gets you to that label. But I really want to talk about that part where you mentioned about having the fear of failure. What would happen if you failed? And what does that say about you then, in your head at least?
So when I say I'm scared of failing, not perform. So when people give me a deal, they give me a great deal, and I feel like I'm not here just to take the money and leave. I want to perform, because if somebody puts their faith in me, puts their money into me, regardless of what it is, I want to reciprocate what they paid for. So it doesn't have nothing to do with family. It doesn't have to do nothing. It has to do with me and who's paying me. That's when it comes to that. Because my mom, everybody back home, I could have 0 points. They could see me running the court for 2 minutes. They happy. That's cool. But when it comes to business, I don't want to fail when someone's putting their faith in me. So that's why I work so hard. And it's like, as far as failing, I if there, there's different, it's hard
There's
because
also this regret, you know, I
exactly
feel like he
regret.
doesn't want to regret in the end.
So if we're talking about failing, some people see me as Zack Lofton, like I'm one of the most humble guys. People don't know me. I'm glad I just interviewed. I'm a humble guy. Like when people say, "Oh, Zack Lofton, come back," like, I just say, "Thank you, thank you, thank you." Like, but what I'm thinking about is, okay, I lost in the finals. That's coming up short. That's failing in a sense. But striving for the finals, which we weren't even supposed to make, like I said, regular season champs,
True.
Dubai finals, right, like Lebanese finals.
Yeah.
We exceeded expectations.
Big time.
So when I strive for the clouds and I work for it and I don't want to, I'm scared of failure. I think that's what makes me the player I am. Like, you know what I mean? So I feel like when I fail and I know I gave my everything, I won't be as hurt.
Yeah.
I'm still hurt, you know, because the guys around me, they want to win, you know? Like, obviously, because I want to win for the guys around me. It's not just me. But if I BS'd, like, mm-hmm. if I didn't give my all, if I was just chilling, like, oh, whatever, I'm here for the money, I'm getting good money, I got money, whatever, I'm going to go home after this, and I failed, I couldn't look at myself in the mirror and be okay with that. Mm-hmm. So as far as failing, everybody's going to fail in life.
Exactly, and it's part of the game. You don't always win, right? You miss the shots a lot of times. It's part of the game, but it's how you deal with the failure as well.
Exactly.
And for you to be up to the faith that other people have put in you, you also need to have faith in yourself. So how do you keep that faith in yourself? How do you stay confident in your game?
Working out.
Cause
the thing is, when you're in a game, you're missing some shots or you're not playing well, you fall back on, cause you get in your head.
Yeah.
All basketball, you're getting hit. You can ask him, you get in your head. Like if you miss two shots, you get taken out, you go and you get a turnover, you're thinking in your head like, what am I doing?
Or a bad call.
Like, what am I doing? Like you said, a bad call, it affects me, it affects my team. I'm not mad because, I'm mad at myself because it hurts them and it hurts me. So I think the way I do it is just hard work. And if I feel like if I work, I can always fall back on that. Like, it's gotten to a routine. Like, when I go to the weight room and I go get treatment and I work on my handles and I go shoot, it's routine. It's regular to me. And if I don't do extra, like if I don't do two times of that, I feel like I didn't work out. But the whole time, this isn't regular to just be in season working out this hard. You know what I'm saying? Everybody doesn't do that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm probably not the most talented player. Like last year, I'm playing the most raw talented player in the league. But people don't know that because I work out so much. Sure. And I care so much about not failing and how to look good. And I got people that really like watching me play. I don't want to let these people down. So if I come out here and don't care and we play against a bad team or whatever, or we doing whatever, and I just come out there and do whatever, okay, I'm cheating them.
But you know something? It's and it has been a part of your journey as well. That, yes, you can train hard, and it's a huge part of your success and you actually being up to that high performance level and your peak performance. But at the same time, if your mental game isn't just as strong for you to handle all of these emotions that come up with the failure or the self-doubt or everything, it's also going to be affecting your game, because you said it, that you work so hard, you train so hard, you do work out, but then there are certain instances within the game that make you be mad at yourself. And then that anger affects your game and your focus as well, affects whether you're present in the game or not, affects how you talk to your teammates or how you talk to the referee or the coach. And that attitude or that emotion, if you want, and that reaction is also going to affect whether you stay or you leave, because you've had several instances within your career where you were either let off some games or let off some teams, like the Golden Gophers, for example,
no, for sure,
right?
Sure.
And that was mainly not because of your talent, because everybody knew you were one of the most talented players, but it was mostly because of your mental toughness or your mental, you know, emotional management.
Right.
Right. So yes, you do put in the work and the training, but how do you then manage your mental to be able to
speak about that?
I need to, what's that story that you just said?
The Minnesota story?
Yeah.
Oh, man. To make a long story short, Minnesota is where I'm from.
Okay.
Like, so I have these things in life where, like, I'm okay. Like, I have visions. Like, it'd be sometimes, like, just say I'm with my friends or I'm drinking a little wine or whatever. You have visions. You think about what could be. When I was younger, I would always think about if I come home and play for the Gophers and be a hometown hero.
Okay.
So when I got to Minnesota, so I went to I had a long story. I went to prep school on the farm in Iowa.
Okay.
After that, I went to junior college.
Okay.
I left prep school early, went to junior college in Houston.
Sanjay, yeah.
Sanjay. After Sanjay, I went to Illinois State. Did well. My coach was leaving. I went to Minnesota. So this is where we stopped. I went to University of Minnesota from Illinois State. I never thought I would get to the University of Minnesota in my life. I get here, I'm here. Everything got to my head. This when I was young, everything got to my head. I was home. I feel like, okay, I done made it now, I'm a hometown hero. I can do whatever I want. I was going out too much.
Okay.
I was being late to practice. Cause I was one of the best, cause I'm talented. I was
Okay.
one of the best players in there. I was with Patino, his son. And I messed that up.
Okay.
And I messed up a couple times in life. Like even what she's talking about, when she said your attitude and blah blah, I'm a fast forwarding from college. This attitude thing, this thing that followed me, it's the reason I'm not making 2 million a year and in Euro League and all this type of
Regardless of the
stuff.
hours you put in practice.
Exactly, regardless. And that's one of them things, like it's so many players that have regrets and what they could have did, what I could have done. I could think about if I didn't tear my hamstring against the Knicks,
You could have been,
I
okay.
could have been. Okay, if I didn't have an attitude at this point in life, I could have been. If you do that, you're gonna crumble.
Then
And
what's the important part here?
the important part
To
is
take
that
that lesson and actually apply
exactly.
now.
So like I used to be worse than I am now, like, and that's crazy. That's a crazy sound. Like I got a lot of texts last year, whatever. But before it was worse, it would affect me more than having to sit down or whatever. Like right now, I could get a tech and still go score 40, 30 points, like whatever. Like,
I see the difference. I'm a
you know what I'm saying? So
yeah.
like, but back then, it's when I was a little bit younger, and I could have been EuroLeague. Like my boy Moose, like I keep bringing him up. Like Moose, like we talk about EuroLeague all the time. He keeps talking about, bro, you could kill in EuroLeague. But when I was in Germany, and then after Germany, I made a bad mistake. I had a deal in Russia, and I didn't go. And they took my FIBA rights. It's only my fourth or fifth year pro. I'm 30 years old. And that's crazy. There's so much stuff that happened that it's too much to unpack in just this one interview. But I'm learning, I'm learning, I'm learning. Now I'm back to the point and getting the money I'm supposed to get. And now, like even yesterday, I had a tech. My first game back.
I was about to
Hoops.
talk about it.
I had one tech. I had in Philippines, in the EASL, I played against Jeremy Lin. I played against Korean teams. I played against Japanese teams. I'm playing against players that's getting $100,000 a month.
Yeah.
And I'm beating them. You know what I'm saying? And we talk about this. Everybody always asks me, like, bro, why aren't you blah blah? Like, why are you just now getting here? Like,
How do you feel about this? How does that make you feel about yourself?
I can't feel away. If I get in my feelings about that, I'm gonna cry. I'm gonna stop working out.
Do you give yourself, though, the time to deal with those emotions?
I have already.
Yeah, good.
And what? That's the thing. Like giving myself time. I can't dwell on stuff, because if I dwell on stuff, me personally, it's gonna kill me.
You
Like,
see, that's the misconception, though.
yeah, like,
If you actually feel the emotion and you work through it, you're not going to be dwelling on it because it's just going to leave. But if you put it back, it's going to keep coming back up until you actually deal with the emotion and take the lesson and apply
so, and you're right. You're right. You're like a doctor or something. That makes sense.
it. That's my court.
Because when I say I can't think about it too much, I have dealt with it. Like I've dealt with it, and I'm here. I'm sitting here. There was a time where I'm like, I'm done. Like I've wasted millions of dollars. When I say millions of dollars, I'm not saying I'm D'Angelo Russell. I'm not saying I'm a max contract guy. I'm not saying that. But I was in the NBA. I've heard everything everybody said, where you're supposed to go, what you're doing. I've played against guys that was getting $7-10 million a year. Couldn't do shit with me. I'm sorry, not, but like we said, like you said, Jeremy Lin, his brother,
His brother,
Kareem
yeah.
Zainu, I'm one of the toughest players to guard, whatever. I've messed up in life, but I've dealt with it, and I have to go forward. Because if I stay in that, time don't wait for nobody. So I have to go past that. And then I gotta work. Okay, that happened. This happened. I take that from this. Try to maximize my money. Maximize for my performance at the same time. I'm not a guy to just take money from somebody and give them whatever.
Yeah.
I could take 40,000 from them or whoever and be like, I'm making money.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't care. But they don't know what they got yet.
Talking
Even
facts.
this is so new right now. This is crazy. I'm glad I did this podcast. I didn't even know if I was gonna do this podcast or not.
Yeah.
But I'm so glad I did at this time. Homemade don't even know what they got right now. Shout out to Geese.
Shout
Even
out to Gabe.
shout out to Faisal. After everything we've been through, after everything we've been through,
Yeah.
shout out to Faisal.
Shout out to Faisal.
Just give him this. That's here nor there. But they don't even know what they got.
Yeah.
They think they got some flashy guy that's gonna bring them a little bit, some whatever, blah blah. I like to win.
100%.
Forget scoring, forget everything. I like to win. So it's just so many misconceptions about me, bro. I just gotta.
As long as you know who you are, and you show up as that every single day, I think also how is trust built? You know, consistent actions over time, and once you keep showing up as who you are, people are gonna know your truth. Right. And this is, you know, LBA is giving that platform through this podcast to the players, for them to for the people and the audience to really get to know you for who you are. So I think that this is a great opportunity for people to know you for who you are as the player and as the person and as your values and as your integrity. Because when you say, I want to show up for you, I want to be up to the faith that you put in me, then that shows about the kind of person you are and your values and your integrity, right? And how you identify yourself. Like, I'm a winner and I will do everything that it takes to
you
get
gotta
there.
Think. You got to think. I don't know if I'm making this too long. I shouldn't
No, not at all. Not at all.
That's your space.
You got to remember, okay, we lost to Suggest. Okay, we lost to Suggest. Back up. No, before that, we play a friendly against who was it, Antronique? Play against friendly Antronique. I didn't make a
last
shot.
Year?
Yeah. Remember, I didn't
I
make
do
eight
remember
shot.
That. I do remember that.
Your sister remembers that. Lay remembers that too. Lay.
Lay.
Remember you wanted them to let me go from Dynamo after I didn't make a shot against Antronique. Okay. So this, but people don't know this. And this is no, like, cause Coach Jod, Faisal, I'll give you a quick story. So, I play against Antronique. I go 0 for 8. I don't make any shots. We come to the first game of the season. We play Bibelos.
Bibelos.
AI. What's AI's whole name?
Ahmad Ibrahim.
Has like 38. I have 11 assists, 12 points, whatever. And they're expecting me to be this big guy scoring 30 points a game, but I'm a game guy. I'm not gonna just go force shit, force. I'm sorry, force stuff all the time. We get to Suggest. We lose. I have a couple points, like 20 something points, whatever. IT has a bad game. He's sick, whatever. They trying to let us go. They don't end up letting us go. We beat Riyadi at home, at their home. Even after that. There was a guy, remember the guy they brought in, they say he was working out, he was trying out for hoops. That point guard that
true,
came in.
True, I remember that.
So in my brain, people don't know this stuff. In my brain, they bringing in a guy to replace me. That's what I'm thinking.
Yeah.
They have a point guard in the stands. I'm walking into practice and I see a guy sitting in the stands. And I'm looking at him. I go into the locker room, I'm like, what's going on? I say to IT, I say, bro, I want to leave. Like, I'm not saying I'm the best player in the world. I don't want to have to try out while I'm in season. I don't think I'm that bad of a player. I was So they come in the huddle. They say, oh, this guy's working out for hoops. You know, so I do whatever. And that lit a fire under me because I'm like, I don't think I'm that bad of a player for someone or somebody to actually fly somebody in to practice against me to see if they want him or me. At this point, I don't know, because they saying this for hoops. No one in hoops is in the gym. There's no cameras in the gym to see this guy. So I don't know what's going on. You know what I mean? And this is all business. I don't hold nothing against nobody in business. But as me as a person, I'm like, what's going on?
Correct me if I'm wrong then, in this case, how important is it for the staff members, whether it's the coach or the management or anything, to really put trust in the player? And how much does that trust affect your performance and how hard you go for that team?
That spectrum is all over the place. You got to understand. So I don't even want to say it because that's not my business about Sean Veer. Some people... It's so many times people are playing so good or they're so good as a player and they do one thing in management. I don't know. It might be the person that's putting the money into it. It might be the sponsor. It might be somebody, anything. And they say, I don't think I'm happy with this. If that's who's driving the boat, if that's who's the captain, everybody underneath has to fall in line. They have to make certain. So it's so weird and that goes back to me saying that's why I work out so many times a day. I'm Zach. I've done certain stuff. I'm not good enough to not get cut somewhere. You get what I'm saying? I can get cut anywhere. So, but it's, you never know.
Yeah.
You never, ever, ever know.
So there's a lot of uncertainty in your game, right? And instability.
I started with Gab as my two guard. He's starting every single game. We get later into the season, if he has a bad game, things change.
So you can't really judge a player in just one.
Exactly. And then an identity of a team changes sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's you know true. What I'm saying?
Yeah,
for and sure. And it's not no one's fault. I mean, it's someone's fault. But, you know what I mean? We can't control everything.
What do you think is the solution in this case then?
There's no solution. I swear, I promise you, there's no solution. Because you got to think, we went to regular season champs last year. We thought we was going like, okay, we did this. We can do everything.
We can do everything, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Riotti made a couple changes.
Exactly.
Yep. We won one game. We won the first game. We thought, this is it.
Guys, I'm sorry. I'm going to have to wrap it. I wish we had more time. Maya, sure. Thank you, like always. Yes. Slime, thank you so much.
I'll be here at the end of the year. This is part one.
Part one?
Make sure you put this as part one.
All right, part one. We need a part two then.
Definitely need a part two. I want people to know I'm not an asshole.
For sure. You like the setup, by the way?
I love it, man. I'm so glad I came here. Like,
yeah.
I've never done this in my life.
Thanks, bro.
I'm an introvert. Believe it or not, I don't like doing this stuff, but you're my guy.
Thank you so much, bro. So, it means a lot. Thank you, Furniture Plus, for the space.
Yeah,
I have one more thing. It's from Postbid Studio.
Okay. Am I supposed to move the mic? I don't want to move
it. Yeah, you can move it. You can move it.
Some expensive stuff going on.
Bro, watch. Unwrap it from here.
Unwrap it from here?
Yep. Right in front. Like the front right here.
No, you do it.
Dude. Right here.
You do it.
Yeah, just go crazy.
Oh, this is mine?
Yeah. It's yours. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, they're basically supposed to be studio. They preserve video games history using digital art and AI magic. I swear to God.
For this month, I can go hang this up.
Yep. Exactly. That's yours.
Hey, Lay, we got to go get a crib for this.
Oh, that's yep. Beautiful.
Yep. There you go, amazing. Man. Yep.
This for me, though. Like.
That's yours, man. You keep
custom,
it.
It's me. Y'all get it someone else?
No. Custom made for you.
This for me.
Yep.
This supposed to be my personality?
Your personality.
So I'm a clown.
No.
That guy right there.
You're the ninja right here.
I like. Thank you, man.
You're welcome. Thank you, Postbit Studio, to be honest.
For sure. I love it.
Guys, it's a wrap. Thank you so much.
Don't forget to like, subscribe, share with the ones you love. Leave a comment below, and we'll see you next time.
See you.